Oh, sorry. I've got a walker later along here. It's pretty cool. It's like one of those at the airport. Anyway, today we seem to have a fair bit of time on our hands being in isolation. So it's not much fun, but what's that sound? Can you hear it? Are you trying to tell me something, Dremel? I think it's carving time. So this week I've decided to bite the bullet and do a carving, as much to my, not disgust, but I don't really enjoy carving as much as I like doing nice ovals and symmetrical shapes. But when it comes to a piece like this one, it's really worthwhile to do a carving, mainly because there's a lot of color in this piece, as you can see up close, and it's really concaved where the color is. So I'm really not going to be able to cut a stone out of it that's going to have a dome. So the only next best thing is to grab the Dremel, grind all the sand out of it, and let's polish it up and see how good it looks. So I thought I'd just quickly show you the process of which bits I use to get from a carving down to the polish. And I start off with this one, which is a hard diamond grit bit. It's about 300 grit. And that gets me shaping, carving, and all sorts of good sand spots out of the piece and stuff like that. Then I go to the 600 grit Nova, and that helps me smoothen all the rough marks that have been made by this tip. And that's quite a good tool, but it does wear down fast. So then once I've done that job, I've got this one here, which is a wooden tip. And I made the wooden tip myself out of a piece of dowel, and then I put the 1200 grit diamond paste onto it. Now this does a fantastic job, and the tip does not wear out very fast at all. So you can get a really good job done on your carving with the 1200 grit. That's kind of the pre-polish. Now I've added just one extra step because I think you need to take your time with polishing carvings. And I've used a felt tip with 8000 grit diamond paste. Now that pretty much, once you're there and you've done your job properly, it's pretty good. Your polish is kind of almost good enough, but I actually add just one more stage with the cerium oxide just to get that proper polish that I really love. And that's on a felt tip, and the felt tip's just got cerium oxide mixed with water. And that's your process. The process of Dremeling is long and slow, and there are two ways you can go about it. You can let the opal do the talking and carve the piece the way the opal wants to, or you can be a bit more aggressive and carve the way you want to carve it. But if you do choose to carve it the way you want to, you run the risk of losing color. So if you are just starting out, I'd suggest let the opal do the talking, and you can learn from that. Rightio. I think I need to do a fair bit more work on this. It's too pitted and undulated. I think it needs to be smoother. I need to take those bumps and lumps out. So, because I'm not totally trained up in this carving, I'm going to go back on to the maybe a finer diamond bit and just smoothen, try and get that a little bit more smooth, because it looks too nuggety and too bumpy, and it could look a bit smoother and nicer. So I'll get back into that now. Also, from last week's video where I showed how much opal can handle or withstand a lot of treatment or chemicals, somebody piped in and said, actually, I gave you a negative review because you've never put it in acetone. So try out acetone. So I'm going to get the same opal this week. I'm going to pour some acetone into the container. All right, here we go. Put the opal in there. And tell you what, for the duration of this video, I'm going to leave that in there. This is, I think, around about a 600 grit Nova tip. I would recommend to do some Dremeling dry every so often, just so you can see all the inclusions and sand spots that you've left behind, because while the piece is wet, it's really hard to see. So you can work on the piece while it's wet to save your tips, but then every so often, dry it out and have a good look, and you will see all of the things you missed. So, this carving takes a long time and I'm getting a bit hungry. Carvings don't just take hours, they take days. So I've had breakfast, lunch, dinner, slept in the same clothes. No, I didn't. Well, this is taking a very long time. You need some patience there to get a nice polish, and especially in the dips where the cutting marks are still present. It's taken me a long time to get this close to a finish where I can polish it. So if I was to polish it a little while ago, I think I would have found cutting marks all over it, would have looked pretty bad. So you do have to spend the time grinding and wearing away those rough marks that are done by the rougher tips, diamond tips. So you have to get the sand out, but you have to get them out with a diamond tip. So it's a catch 22. If you've done a good job of getting all of your cutting marks out, scratches and inclusions, and you get to the polish, well, the polish is the most easiest part of the whole process. And it's the most exciting too, because as you polish it and you rub that cerium oxide off, you see that gorgeous shine come through and the end result is clear.
Let's have a close look here. Getting a nice polished surface there. Get all that polish out of the dips. You can see it's pretty close.
This opal has been in acetone for around about an hour, and I shall get it out and I'll put it in some water to dilute it. Get a towel and give it a nice wipe down again. there is absolutely no change whatsoever again. So acetone is absolutely fine for opals as well. Let me take it to the light box. I'll get a closer shot for you so you can see it hasn't changed at all.
Now this little fella has been through the wars. It's been put through all sorts of solutions and held up, and I'm really proud of it. Now there's only a few things that this guy cannot handle, and that is a heated flame for a long time. It will blow apart. And dropping on hard surfaces won't go well either.
So we finally finished. It's been 2 days and lots of abrasives. I've gone backwards and forwards on abrasives because I've missed spots. Then I've found out that there's more cutting marks in there. So I go back to the rough diamond tip, then further down again. It's been a bit of a back and forth. It's probably a really good idea to loop the opal and look very closely at where all your scratches are. But finally, after a few sleeps, many cups of coffee, a zupa dupa and some other stuff, lunch, we've finally got a nice polish on the piece and it looks quite nice. So I've still left the rough part on the back so you can see that it looks like a natural nobby. I could grind all that down and make the whole thing polished, could do that, but I've chosen not to for now. I just wanted to make a nice video for you guys of carving and exposing the color bar with a Dremel for you guys. So there you go, it's all done, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm going to go and have a beer now. Catch you later.